Lala Yahweh Bashim Yawashai Bashim Racha Kadash, double honors unto the apostles, the GMS who rule well, who I learned the truth from, and salutations unto the brothers and a few sisters that take heed. Quick lesson coming here, the Spirit just hit me about why it is important to trust in the Lord and the Lord only. Okay? Because in this world is complete backwards, man. Okay? You have to know that this world is completely backwards to the will of the Most High, which is who you know as God and His Son Yahusha. All right, so everything you grew up in this world knowing, believing, you know, living your traditions, the majority of it is wickedness. All right, and this is how the world is set up, because the world was given into others' hands. All right, it was given pursuant to Job 9:24 into the hands of the wicked, which is Esau. All right, so this whole world is set up as a deterrent for truth, you know. But again, man, in this world, what kind of sparked me or factor? I was watching this guy, Faraz Zahabi. He's a MMA coach in Montreal. He's a GSP's coach, George St. Pierre. But yeah, this dude, he's Lebanese, right? And he's a Muslim. But this dude is skeptical. You know, he's a skeptical guy. And we know these like Ishmaelites, these Muslims that come up. They're very, you know, they try to be witty. They try to be very skeptical and critical. You know. But basically, he said how he grew up. I think it was the imam who asked him, who do you love, God or your mother more? And he said he was like 9 or 10 years old, and he said his mother. And the imam even, he told him that you should love God first, because, you know, if your mom dies, what next? You know, what's your foundation? You just fell apart. So you have to make God your foundation, you know? And that was a good point. That's what the scriptures tell you. You know, that's what the scriptures actually tell you, man, when you read it. You know, I'm not trying to quote him like he's the source. I'm just saying, when I heard that, I said, yeah, that's true. You know, and basically the point I'm making is with this guy, Faraz Zahabi, he said, oh, after that, my whole mind frame shifted. And he kind of had the same mind frame I had when I was young as well, which for whatever reason, I don't know why I had it. But basically he said how, when, you know, people make things big and, you know, like events, man-made things, he said, you know, people hype it up and make it very big. He said, I was downscaled it. I never looked at it as a big thing or as a big work, you know, because you're putting that trust and that faith and, you know, of man and all these things. And I kind of had that thing growing up, and people, you know, at times you think you're crazy, because again, this world you grew up in, man, it teaches you, you know, love yourself. You know, when you have your birthday, go all out. You know, your birthday lasts for a week. Some people, they party all fucking week. They go crazy. You know what I mean? Everything, Christmas, they go crazy lavish. You know, Easter, fucking Halloween. You know, basically vanity, man. Vanity. And from an early age, I kind of knew that all this shit is really vain, man. You know, all this shit is just vain. You know, because my mind processed things that I would look... I would add things up, and I would look, I'd say, okay, I get a job, I get this, I get that, but then what? Then you die, then it goes into, you know, you don't even keep it. So for me, it was all vanity. So when he said that, I said, that's a good point. So that's why I wanted to make this lesson on why it's so important. You know, because in the world, you know, it's all about your mother, your father, your children, everything, except serving the Most High. You serve men, you serve women, you serve children, instead of serving the Most High, right? We're talking about, if you men out there who are family men, your fathers, and you have children, and you wake up to this word, or you not even wake up, you get it presented to you, you know, and you say, okay, I'm going to make a change, or you don't make a change, you know, in your family, right? Because you might base, you still base off what they do. They eat pork. Okay, I'm still gonna eat the pork. You know, or the honey bought a breaded shrimp. You know, we're going to eat that tonight for dinner, you know, or whatever the case is in general, you know, whatever the case is in general, but you're serving them. You know, they're still bringing the Christmas tree in the house. You know, they're doing all that shit. So you're still in that mind frame of pleasing them instead of the Most High. So you cannot please anything more than the Most High. So this is, I'm going to start off with this. Like, I went on a rant, but this says Psalms 37:1. Fret not thyself because of evildoers. Fret meaning get vexed or mad. Neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb, man. Yo, man, these people, there's no denying it. You know, they're living a lavish, luxurious, lascivious, full life, man. You know, of greed and lust and wickedness, but it's such a high pinnacle. You know, to the point where it's sad because these young children, these Jakes, I'm talking about. We don't care about heathens, but I'm talking about Jakes. You know, these so-called blacks, Latinos, Native Americans. They grow up. And nowadays, man, it's easy, man. Like a 5 or 6 year old, he already has some sense about him. He can have a phone, and on that phone, he can already be on Snapchat, Instagram, and he's seeing all these things that these wicked ass Jakes are doing, man. You know, he's seeing all the money. He's seeing the stacks of money. He's seeing all the shiny, glittery diamonds and gold and the jewelry. You know, all the cars and all the so-called the rewards, you know, of the wicked, right? So it's a sad thing, man. There's no guidance, right? Verse 3, trust in the Lord Yahweh and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. See, so the Lord is your substance, man. He's your rest. You know, he's the one in life where brothers are moving through life, man. Whatever happens, man, shifts happen in life. You know, there's all kinds of shifts that happen. You know, your family could turn against you, your mother, father, or whoever, they can pass away. You know, your children, they can be taken from you, man. Your woman can leave you, commit adultery on you, whatever, man. But if you have the Lord in the center of your life, man, all the time, you know, and he's your rest. You know, that doesn't shift. You know, hey, shit just happens, man. You know? So you gotta keep the faith in the Lord. You don't say, oh, screw this thing. Then what are you gonna go serve? Because you're serving somebody, bro. You know, in this world, as soon as you're born, they stamp your ass with a birth certificate. You know, you're clocked in, man. You know, you're in the matrix, man. You're in the fucking matrix, bro. When you clock in, you're serving somebody. Okay, whether that baby grows up in an Israelite home that knew they're Israelite somehow, or whatever age that Israelite wakes up and sees the men, that's when you start serving the Lord. So if shit happens to you, you're going to stop serving the Lord because something like that happened to you? Whatever the case is, man. Brothers, I know brothers that have kids, man. And they have forsaken the children, or the children have been taken from them forcibly. Brothers forsake their families, you know, lose their jobs, their careers, you know, all kinds of shit, man. So, you know, you're gonna be tried in the word, man, in this truth. Verse 4, delight thyself also in the Lord Yahweh, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord Yahweh, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord Yahweh, and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Who is that, man? That's Esau. And you're seeing what... Listen, man, this is his kingdom. Whatever he derives, or slack, not derives... whatever he ponders upon, muses upon, he can bring it forth to pass, man. Whatever device. Okay? He can do that. You know? And he is doing it. Fucking, he's talking about sex bots and virtual reality and all this shit. These people are going to be lost in the sauce, man. you know? But you can't fret, you can't get angry, man. Oh, I wish I had that, I wish I want that, you know? You gotta really, this thing is really, is about denying yourself, man, in this word. It's really about denying yourself. And in this world, you're nobody, man. Some brothers, there's a big spectrum in this thing, you know? But I can tell you there's no brothers in the shelters, you know? You might have to, you might be evicted, you know, and couch surfing and whatnot. And there's no brothers that are fucking, we call it, CEOs, man. You know, like top Fortune 500 companies. But some brothers are low, some brothers are high. You know, some brothers aren't doing well, some brothers are doing well. And the brothers that are doing well help out the brothers that don't. You know? But the point is, the work comes first, man. This word, whatever, in whatever situation you're in, you know. Verse 8: cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil. Right. So it's not about being a paramilitary or vigilante group and doing any acts, man. We're all about the spiritual. We're waiting for the Father, man. You know, and His Son. That's what we're that's what we're waiting for, you know. For evildoers, verse 9, shall be cut off, but those that wait upon the Lord Yahweh, right, they shall inherit the earth for yet a little while, and the wicked shall not be. Yea, thou shalt diligently consider his place, and it shall not be. See, because Esau, Edom will be according to Obadiah 1 and 18, 17, 18. It says the house of Judah and the house of Eve and the house of Joseph shall be for house of fire, I believe, and Esau shall be for stubble. You know, the house of Edom. See, so it's talking about all the tribes of Edom, the whole house, the collective house of Edom. And after that, really, in the kingdom, you're not even gonna, Edom's not even gonna have a land. The land of Edom will belong to the land of Judah. Judah's going to inherit the land of Edom. Because really, Edom put the most hell upon which tribe? Judah. Right? Through you know what already. We don't even have to say it. You know? But Edom shall not... You're not even going to... Oh, where's Edom? You know? It said, thou shalt diligently consider his place, and it shall not be. But the meek shall inherit the earth, and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. See how spiritual that is? Then the Lord Yahushua say that the meek shall inherit the earth. Right? And King David is saying that. The wicked plotteth against the just and gnasheth upon him with his teeth. The Lord Yahweh shall laugh at him, for he seeth that his day is coming. Man, that's a bad scripture, man. You Edomites, your day is coming, man. Alright, the Most High is laughing at you right now. See, and Esau, he has already finished his plot. Rex 84, King Alfred's plan, you know, this whole RFID Mark of the Beast deal, 5G. They're trapping you people, man, in the fucking grid. They're locking off the internet, man. Internet, listen, man, internet is going to be locked off real soon, man. Okay? The internet is going to be locked off real soon. The wicked have drawn out this. That was really it on that. We can go on, but the point was, again, in the trust, right? And I got Judith 9 in the Apocrypha, verse 6. Yea, what things thou didst determine were ready at hand, and said, lo, we are here, for all thy ways are prepared, and thy judgments are in thy foreknowledge. This is talking about the Most High. See? So everything's prepared, man. The Most High has his, that's why, what do you think the apostles and the brothers always say? The Most High plays chess. You know, he's 100 steps ahead of you. He's infinity ahead of you, man. You know what I mean? There's no ratio. It's like 100 to 0. So the Most High is ahead of you. It says his judgments are in his foreknowledge. Fore meaning before. So he everything is set up, man. There's a blueprint. Like the brothers in Dallas, the old, and the brother in London, the old.